I'm Dawna Lee Heising, and today we're here at the 2013 NAMM show. This is the biggest event in the music industry, and this year they're expecting 90,000 attendees from around the world. The festival lasts from January 24th through the 27th, and we're here at Media Day today. And thank you to the Lippin Group for letting us come.
We're here for the NAMM show, 2013 NAMM show, which is a gathering of people who make, sell, or use music and sound products. For those of us who are in the music industry, this is like our annual gathering. And so it's a traditional trade show where new products are introduced and sales meetings take place and retailers and distributors get together with manufacturers, but it happens to be music. So on top of all that is this great excitement about the artists and about what is really breakthrough technology, or even in some cases I think we have one of the oldest Stradivarius violins that'll be here on display. So it's really the yin and yang of new products and this love of tradition that we have of handcrafted beautiful instruments that'll last well into the next century or beyond. Well, so basically NAMM is a platform, right? I mean, basically it's just a place. And all these companies come and all these people come from, I think, almost 100 countries. And they're the ones who bring all this. I mean, they've toiled all year long to invent new products or to, build. And literally people over workbenches building these things, And they come here to NAMM. Sometimes it's the biggest trip of the year for them. Sometimes it's the only trip of the year for them. And they come here to California and it's beautiful and nice weather. I mean, some places they're coming from, it's not very nice right now. So they're excited to be here. They're excited sometimes to see friends and peers. The NAMM show has actually been going on since 1901.
Hi, I'm Star from IK Multimedia.
And tell us about your company.
Well, IK Multimedia is the leading provider of mobile apps. It's music creation apps and accessories for your iOS devices and now your Android devices as well. What we have to show you right now is some new products. This is called iRig Blueboard. It's the very first MIDI expression pedal board for your iOS device, and it's Bluetooth. So what does that mean? It means that you can have this wirelessly sitting on the floor and set up four different banks or presets to go with your Amplitude software or any MIDI core MIDI software on your iPad, your iPhone, or your iPod Touch. And then you could just wirelessly change the devices. So if you're playing your guitar through your iRig and your Amplitude, you can just sit there and change your sounds. And it will, you know, if you want to go from like a Jimi Hendrix sound over to a Marley sound, never taking your hands off the guitar, it's the iRig Blueboard. You can find out more information about it from ikmultimedia.com. Another Best in Show winner that we got from CES, now we're showing at NAMM here, 2013, is called iRig HD. iRig HD is the way that you plug your guitar or bass into your iOS device. Well, IK Multimedia's claim to fame 3 years ago was making one of the most popular guitar and bass interfaces called the iRig. It went through the audio jack. This one now goes in digitally. So you can use your Lightning connector or your 30-pin connector and go in digitally. What else is great about it? It has 24-bit analog to digital conversion. So it does all of your pristine audio sound within the device.
Wow, that's great. Now, what award did it win at CES?
It won Best in Show. The Blueboard also won Best in Show.
Oh my gosh, congratulations. Well, thank you very much. That was great.
You're welcome.
Go for it. Okay, so my name's Alexander Adami, aka Alex Plays, alexplays.com, and also ifixyourmix.com. If you're having any trouble, I can fix your mix. And I have a whole series of courses with a company called Mac Pro Video. And for those of you that like to use a DAW that can do a little bit more, kind of go to 11, so to speak, check out Digital Performer 8. I have a whole series of courses. I'll be adding more. DP8 is like the Ferrari, okay, of DAWs. 64-bit, you can do a whole bunch of things that you can't do with the other guys. I don't want to mention any professional names, but you can do a lot with Digital Performer. You can also sequence your show live, control the lights. Can you believe that? You can do all of this with all the different features in Digital Performer 8. Check it out, macprovideo.com. I'm Alexander Dami, aka Alex Plays, alexplays.com, and ifixyourmix.com.
this is really just a quick moment for us to be able to welcome you. The NAMM show is where I think the global music industry comes together for a couple days of new products, which we're looking at here, celebrating the traditions that we have. I mean, there's products that you'll see on the show floor that are being made today that will be played by our great, great, great grandchildren. So we're an industry that really has our foot in two areas, technology and where music is taking us, how easy it is to learn to play music now and enjoy music, share it, record it. Yet at the same time, these beautiful handcrafted instruments of intrinsic value that will last forever. So I think that's one of the most beautiful things of our industry is that we are pushing forward into the future while at the same time respecting our past and our tradition.
Grover makes guitars. Everybody, I think, hopefully knows Grover's history as one of the great, I think, disruptive guitar makers in the last century, right? This guy, when I was a teenager, and I grew up listening to, you know, classic rock and you know, I was a rock music lover. And I started playing in bands when I was 15, you know, when I was 12 years old, I started playing guitar. When I was about 15 or 16, all of a sudden these new guitars came on the scene and they all had his name on them, Jackson guitars. And everybody in town, like I grew up in Orange County here, everybody here either wanted these guitars or played them.
Thanks, Matt. This guy's a rock star. He's a rock star here. He built this amazing tool that, you know, really grabbed me, I guess, by the heartstrings, because my schedule is pretty hectic. It's touring, it's playing festivals, it's living in the studio, it's rehearsing with bands, it's MDing, it's all kinds of things. But I actually grew up in Davenport, Iowa, in what felt like a million miles away from music and music culture that I was passionate about. So to be able to have a tool like Chromatic where I can get in the studio, I can create something, and then I could potentially, you know, share it out to kids all over the world, interact with them, annotate, teach them, help them better their skills so eventually they can get to a place where they can make music, which I'm so passionate about, their career or their livelihood is something that I feel extremely strong about. And I really think, you know, being so involved in kind of EDM and dance music, which kids are so excited about, this kind of missing link where you see me on a stage pushing play on a CDJ and kids expect they can do the same. But the reality is you gotta learn music, you gotta know how to make music, because you can only get so far with sound design. You gotta be able to articulate what you wanna say. And I think the tools this guy is building, you know, are really incredible for that.
It takes its family name from the great composer Felix Mendelssohn, whose descendants were the owner. We have no idea where this violin was for over 200 years until it surfaced in Berlin, Germany, in the hands of Lily von Mendelssohn, who was tragically killed in a car accident on her 28th birthday, leaving behind her small children and her violin as her legacy.
So a lot of people think that the TC Helicon, all these vocal pedals, are for pop singers and stuff like that. But, you know, I like pop music, but I wouldn't necessarily call myself like a full pop act. I have a full band behind me. I just get bored when I'm on stage sometimes. I play, you know, I only do vocals. So sometimes, you know, I can do different things. I use the TC Touch 2, actually, on stage. I can change things, I can use different effects, and it makes things interesting for me. And it's really easy to use. I actually literally just got this model like less than a week ago and just been screwing around with it. And it's really, really easy to use. Anyone can use it. So yeah, thank you.
And I have with me Alex Skolnick from Testament and the Alex Skolnick Trio to demonstrate the world's first variable instrument performance modeling amplifier. Now, what that means is not only is this an electric guitar amplifier, it's a bass guitar amplifier and an acoustic guitar amplifier as well.
Of course, I want to thank AmpKit and Agile Partners for having me. It's a wonderful, wonderful product. As a recording artist, one of the things that we find very difficult, and I'm sure that you guys can relate to it, is having a chance to plug up wherever you are, whether that's in hotels, you're in the studio, you just want to go through some ideas that you have yourself. And I think this is something that absolutely solves that problem.
What's unique about this drum and what this drum is made out of is actually, we're calling it a concrete snare drum, but it's made out of cast stone. So it's a blue stone ground up with a polymer, which creates a very thin, and after this you guys can come look at it, it's a remarkably thin and lightweight snare drum for being made out of stone. We have a 3P butt plate, which is a three-position butt plate. So what this little gear shift lets you do is you can keep your throw off exactly where it's set, and then you just flick it to any of three positions in the studio or on stage, and you're able to get three completely different snare sounds and snare tensions with that.
We're going to do a webcast on Friday, in which I'm going to perform a couple of the tunes that I have written from my latest CD, Moving Forward. It's just going to be a great time, you know, talking about my career in baseball as well as music and how important music has been in my life. As a youngster, going to a performing arts high school and spending 4 years there, and then just having the opportunity to play with the Yankees for a little bit over 16 years, and how music sort of prepared me to going into this crazy world of professional sports, and how it kept me grounded. Music never really left me, and after I stopped playing baseball, you know, I sort of came back here, and I was just fortunate to make this connection with NAMM and being able to do a lot advocating for music and going to Capitol Hill and doing everything that I can to let people know how important music has been in my life and how can they benefit from it as well.
I've been with Dean for several years, and I was with ESP before them and with Jackson before that, and you know, a lot of guitar players, our career is just based on our tools, and I'm very picky about the guitars that I play, and I don't know any guitar player that's, you know, worth his salt that isn't picky about what he uses. And for me, with when I went to Dean, I found that the guitars were very responsive, and that one of the most important things was the attention to detail. Also for the relationship with me as an artist, because at previous companies I was with, you know, the guitars were good, but the relationship was sour. And I found that being with Dean was really good for me because, you know, they took care of me as an artist. They took care of the guitars. They also knew what the public liked. So, those of you that are distributors, you know that the younger generation, they want guitars that look cool, that play great, that are affordable, and that their icons use. And for me, I'm flattered to be considered an icon, but, you know, I'm just a guitar player, and to have this kind of backing and support from a company that is as reputable as Dean is, it was really flattering.
Got a couple of others for Dave that we're releasing this year, so it's going to be awesome. Thanks.
Let me show you what that sounds like. Let's do that now. putting out a ukulele aerobics play-along DVD. I think Look Out Zumba. Okay. Well, I thought I heard the captain say, they need my money down. Tomorrow is our sailing day. That's G7. Pay me my money down. I said, pay me, pay me, pay me my money down. Pay me or go to jail. Pay me my money down. Just two chords. If it's not one, it's the other. And your part is, pay me my money down, right? No matter what I say, you always say, pay me my money down. Well, if I were a rich man's son, I'd sit on the river and watch it run. I said, pay me, pay me, pay me my money down. Pay me or go to jail. Pay me my money down. Well, if I were Mr. Gates, strings. It's the chugga 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 strum. If you have a pick or a long fingernail, you can do the guiro sound. Of the ukulele section, dramatic. And one thing, is, let's do it on a C chord. Drums and you'll hear the most beautiful sound.